not something new. And I'll give you very specific examples. You're all able-bodied people here because in your childhood you are vaccinated against polio. You rarely see people crippled now because you have done very well with polio vaccination. Whooping cough is gone. Measles is gone. There are very few pockets remaining. Tetanus, those who know tetanus, which used to kill a lot of newborns, is gone. And these are vaccines we give. You take your children for vaccination and you have seen you protect them. They grow into adult. Recently, you have introduced the rotavirus vaccine to protect children from diarrhea, the pneumococcal to protect them from chest infection. These are new vaccines and they have made a difference. Here in Zambia, 3 years ago, we introduced the cholera vaccine, which has
passed 100,000 vaccinated individuals in Zambia, and we're still moving. And you know, this initiative that we're doing with FecoSoc is what we've been talking about all along. Our approach to healthcare service delivery in Zambia is that of a multifaceted approach. Each and every player has to come in and play a role in ensuring that you know, they talk health and encourage people to seek health so that highly healthy Zambian population, which is economically productive. So we also came on board and brought in the civil society organizations that we've been training. We noted that Tindola has been having low uptake for the COVID-19 vaccine. That's why we had that interaction with our individuals, civil society in Kitwe. And right now we're in Indola, and we just want to commend ECOSOC, which is an AU technical arm, for coming on board to support this interaction that we're having. And as you can see, whilst we're here, we're also carrying out vaccinations.